Hello! In this video, we will take a look at ball and hinge joints. Again, I've prepared a scene. I've made these three wall pieces made of masonry and a door made of wood. The door has the prop checkbox ticked, so it's dynamic, and the wall pieces are static. I guess you could call that some kind of door, but it's not exactly what we are going for. So let's add some hinges for the door. And a tip here is that, for example, if you're creating hinges or joints for a door like this, I create them as children to the door. So I select the door, new, and a joint. And I move it over here, up a bit. Control D to duplicate it. And I move another one up here. And there are three kinds of joints: ball, hinge, and prismatic. And we're starting with looking at the ball hinge. So now that I've placed these hinges here, and you can see that they are just here between the wall and the door, I'll take a look in the game. And now it works more like a door, but it's a bit sticky, the door. And that's because there are friction between the ground and the door down here. Let's fix that. I pull this wall piece up a bit by holding S and dragging this gizmo up. And then I'm raising the door a voxel. And you can see that the joints are following along with the door because they are children to the door. And if we try again, we can see that the door works much better. But there's still a couple of problems. One issue is that the door, it grabs on this edge here. And that might be fine. But this other thing is worse. There's no collision between the door and this part of the wall. Let's take a look at how we can solve that. If we select one of the joints, we can see that it has the property collide. And if I check this property, what this does is that the two shapes that this joint is binding together, in this case the door and this wall, they will now collide with each other. I do the same for the joint down here, and we'll take a look. Now it correctly collides with this wall here. And if I try to open the door in this direction, it gets really difficult because there's tension between the door and the wall down here. But that's usually how door works, so that's fine. A nice thing with using ball joints for doors is that if I shoot one of the hinges, the door will hang like this on the remaining joint, which is a nice effect in the game. And if I want to stop this effect, that I can pull the door a little bit back here towards this direction with the added tension, I can put another piece down here like that. Now there's this stop for the door. And if you want to lock a door, you just duplicate one of these joints. And you can put it here. Let's just, for the sake of it, create another voxbox as a child to this door. We make it a bit light gray, like that. It's really big, which we don't want. And let's make it metal. And because this voxbox is now a child of the dynamic door, it will move together with the door when the door moves. So now we have a locked door. And if I shoot the lock, the door is open. Let's remove the lock. And we'll take this lock part we made and move it over here and make a duplicate. Move one down there. And now we have nice indications of where the joints are. So if you want to shoot them out in the game, you know where to aim. If we look at the joints, we can see that they have these rot strength and rot spring properties. And rot strength is the rotational strength of the joint. Increasing this value will make the door more difficult to open. It will take more power to pull it open. And the rot spring will make the door want to return to its original position. But if you pull the door open past a certain point, it will get a new position that the spring wants to go back to. I think it's easier if I just display it. So rot strength I can set to fairly low value, like 0.1. And we can leave rot spring at the default 0.5. And now you can see that the door doesn't swing freely anymore. And when I pull it, it like flexes back. Let's lower the rot strength even more. 0.01. And we'll do the same for the other one. 0.01. Let's lower the rot spring a little bit. 0.1. And 0.1. For both of them. And here we have a pretty nice door. So let's remove these joints and these hinge indicators. And now I select the door. I select new joint. And in the type parameter here, I type hinge. And you can see that this joint now has this yellow line, which describes the rotational axis of the joint. So we will need to flip this up by holding down shift and dragging on the x-axis, the red one. And I'm moving it up here and I'm putting it at the center of the door. And we have the same kind of issues that we had before with it not colliding with this wall piece. But you can see that even if we just use one joint, because it's a hinge that only rotates around this axis, the door doesn't hang loosely like the other door did when there was only one joint holding it up. But another nice thing we can do with the hinge is that we can enter the limits for the hinge. This is the minimum and maximum angle of hinge rotation. So if I write 0 and 90, I get these two indicators. If I go in and look at the door, you can see that I can't move it at all. And if that happens, it's because the hinge is upside down. It actually wants to rotate the other way around. I just turn it 180 degrees. And we try again. And here you can see I have a door and I can't open it past 90 degrees. And in this case, I can even remove this threshold back here, because the door won't be able to move past that 0 degree in that direction. Maybe it should be like 0 to 170. Just like the ball joint, we can increase the rod strength to get a more natural opening door. Let's try 0.01. And we lower the rod strength, 0.05 maybe. Let's take a look. Oh, quite springy. So let's lower the rod spring even more, 0.005. That's all for the video on ball and hinge joints.